Liquidity Preference Theory of Interest, Part 3. This is Part 3 of the series. For the benefit of those who didn't view the first two parts, I have given the links in the description. Now, the lesson. It is the demand for and supply of money which determines the rate of interest. Already we have learned the derivation of the demand curve for money. It is time for us to fix the supply curve of money. Rate of interest is measured along the y-axis and quantity of money is measured along the x-axis. Obtaining the supply curve of money is so simple. The supply of money in an economy is fixed by the monetary authority of a country. Hence, supply of money is insensitive to the interest rate changes. Though interest rate in the economy varies in the market as 9%, 6% and 3%, the supply of money remains unchanged at 11 crores of rupees. The curve MS represents the supply curve of money. It is vertical and parallel to y-axis. Let us fix the demand curve for money, LP, in the same graph. Both the curves cut at the point E. The rate of interest is 6%. At that rate of interest, the demand for money is 11 crores of rupees and supply of money is also 11 crores of rupees. Since the demand for money is equal to the supply of money at point E, 6% is the equilibrium rate of interest. Any disturbance to this equilibrium will set in motion the market forces and bring back the original equilibrium at point E. Due to some wrong decision by the market participants, the interest rate may move up. The market rate of interest is 9%. At that interest, the liquidity preference or demand for money is only for 7 crores. But the supply of money is 11 crores. Since the demand for money is less than the supply of money, there is disequilibrium in the market. The surplus cash in the market is 4 crores. Cash as such is not yielding any return. In the market, the interest rate is high. It means return is high and the bond prices are low. In order to take advantage of low bond prices and high interest rate, people start buying bonds. The bond prices go up. The interest rate falls. Original equilibrium at E is restored. Demand for money balances itself against the supply of money. Thus, equilibrium rate of interest 6% is brought back. At times, the market rate of interest may fall. It is 3% now. At this rate of interest, liquidity preference or demand for money is 15 crores. But the supply of money is 11 crores. The demand for money is greater than the supply of money. The excess demand for money is 4 crores. In the market, the interest rate is low. It means the bond prices are high. In order to take advantage of higher bond prices, people start selling the bonds. As they sell bonds, the bond prices start falling down. This pushes up the interest rate. The demand for money becomes equal to the supply of money. The original equilibrium E is re-established. Thus, once again, the equilibrium interest rate 6% will be prevailing in the economy. This is how the equilibrium interest rate is determined by the demand for and supply of money. So long the demand and supply conditions remain constant in the market, any change in the equilibrium interest rate is taken care of by the market forces and the original equilibrium is brought back. In the next video, we shall analyze how the shifts in the demand and supply curves affect the equilibrium rate of interest. Before finishing this lesson, let me ask just only one true or false type question. Whenever equilibrium interest rate is disturbed in the market, it is the central bank which brings back the equilibrium. If your answer is false, you are right. We shall meet again.